Hi friends, welcome to Margi Newspaper Simplified. In today's video, we are going to discuss one important article related to artificial intelligence. The Hindu, we are having this article from The Hindu, Responsible AI, the need for ethical guardrails. Title was related to AI and ethics. Without adequate safeguards, AI can widen social and economic schisms leading to discriminatory outcomes. So they are critically analyzing this artificial intelligence. And while explaining this AI, they first start with history of artificial intelligence. So they are quoting one important example here. Czech writer Karel Čapek first mentioned robots in 1920s play. And from that point, you can say that humans were dreaming about these robots and artificial intelligence. So they are using this word intelligent machines here. So from then, humans have dreamed about intelligent machines, and now you can see that AI is in every corner of human life nowadays. Now AI's exponential growth, how this happened then? From 1920s, that mention of robots in place, and then how this growth happened. So today, where you can find artificial intelligence? So they have given some examples here, like recommendations we get on our favorite streaming or shopping websites, like Flipkart or Amazon. Then GPS mapping technology, there you can see artificial intelligence. And whenever you are sending any email, then there is predictive text. That means if you are typing something, then it will suggest you that what you are typing. So it will complete your statement then. So these are various places where you can see artificial intelligence. Now, what is the basic behind this? That more you use this artificial intelligence, more data you will generate. And the more you generate this data, more smarter your machine will get. So that is the basic behind this, that more data generation, the more it will get smarter. And with automation, big data and various algorithms, which are like in every corner of human life nowadays, sometimes it is also said that algorithm is the king. Algorithm is the king. This is very frequently said. So artificial intelligence, it can be beneficial for us in many aspects, like eradicating hunger, poverty and various diseases. In this various fields, you can use artificial intelligence. Now, next they are talking about what are the positive and negative aspects of artificial intelligence. So for better and for worse. Firstly, they are talking about AI for better, and in that they have mentioned some data here. Artificial intelligence helped increase crop yields, raised business productivity, improved access to credit, and made cancer detection faster and more precise. So these are various areas where AI has proved that it is a better kind of technology. Now, again, there is one data here. It could contribute more than $15 trillion to the world economy by 2030, which is nothing but adding 14% to global GDP. 14%. This is a very big number. Now, Google has identified over 2,600 user cases. So these are some applications, 2,600 use cases for AI for good worldwide. So AI for good, under this heading, they have identified about 2,600 use cases, that these are the areas where you can use artificial intelligence. Then artificial intelligence, it may act as an enabler on 79% of sustainable development goals. About 79% in cases, you can see that it will be beneficial for your sustainable development goals. Now, this was the study published in The Nature. The Nature, they have published this study. And in that same journal, they have also published that it can hinder about 35% of SDG targets. Now, this is the area where you will see that there are some critical issues related to artificial intelligence. So, 35% of cases, you will see that AI can hinder the growth of these sustainable development goals in 35% cases. Now, how this is happening, that it is hindering the growth of sustainable development goals? First of all, they have mentioned that artificial intelligence, it requires massive computational capacity. It means it will require a lot of data. So these are like power data hungry machines. So if you are having these kind of data hungry machines, and then in that case, you can see digital exclusion can happen. So it could compound digital exclusion, and through that it is affecting this sustainable development goals. After that, intelligent machines are there, and they are performing those tasks which are generally performed by humans. And if it is happening, then it is creating new kind of inequalities through the issue of employment. Then investments are likely to shift to countries where AI related work is already established. That means those countries which are having good AI related expertise, in that area investments are getting shifted. And this, if this is happening, in that case the gap between countries, at the same time gaps within country are also widening. So that is against the sustainable development goal. And in that case they have given one data here that big tech companies like Google, Amazon, Apple and Facebook, these are worth a staggering $5 trillion, which is more than the GDP of just about every nation on this earth. $5 trillion, that is the worth of these companies, Google, Amazon, Apple and Facebook. Now moving forward, they are discussing, just as AI has potential to improve billions of lives, it can also create new problems. Now what are the new problems which are created by AI? For example, if you are having facial recognition and surveillance technologies. So these technologies are discriminating against people of color and minorities, and this is being found at various places. At the same time, there is also example that AI enhanced recruitment engine, through the data it is getting, it taught itself that male candidates were preferable to female. Now this was also many times seen. Then comes another issue, privacy worry. What is the issue of privacy related to AI then? First of all, data, and whenever you are having data, you are providing that data to that machine, and machine is learning itself. In that case, you can see the digital footprints which we are providing, and because of that you can see the privacy issue can generate. So digital footprints being harvested and sold without our knowledge or informed consent. Today it is no exaggeration that algorithms know us better than we know ourselves. Algorithm know us better. They can nudge your behavior towards any particular activity. For example, our level of addiction to our devices, level of addiction, for example, mobile phones, and the cases like Cambridge Analytica. And these cases show us that there is a warning sign related to AI, that you need to have proper regulation related to artificial intelligence. And in that case, they have also given, algorithm is the king. This phrase is given, and humans are responsible for this, because the data which that algorithm is using is being given by humans only. Now what we can do then, if this is the scenario, what we can do and what should be our priority? First of all, we should have regulations related to artificial intelligence. Then they have given one approach, whole of society approach, WHOLE, whole of society approach, to develop broad based ethical principles. And this approach, when you are talking about any particular country, then this approach should rest upon a larger approach, that is whole of the world approach. Now at global level, what are the initiatives that are being taken? At global level, first of all, United Nations Secretary General has released roadmap on digital cooperation, and that is a good starting point in this case. And it contains a global cooperation, so artificial intelligence is used in a manner that is trustworthy, human rights based, safe and sustainable, and which will promote peace. So that is the basic objective of this roadmap on digital cooperation. At the same time, UNESCO is also release some document, draft recommendation on the ethics of artificial intelligence to its member states. Draft recommendation they have released. And when you talk about India, then there is a strategy related to artificial intelligence which is released by Niti Aayog. Now if you see this strategy report, Niti Aayog strategy report, in that case there are some important points which can be beneficial for our exam. So national strategy for artificial intelligence. Now we will discuss some important points from this report, National Strategy for Artificial Intelligence. First of all, at the start of this report, they have given global developments in artificial intelligence. Global developments, what is happening at global level. In that case, they have quoted first of all China and UK. So China and UK estimate that 26% and 10% respectively of their GDPs in 2030 will be sourced from AI related activities and businesses. So that is the estimate, that China and UK will have these much amount of GDP through AI related activities. Then US published its AI report in December 2016. So they are recognizing this technology in their administration. Then France published the AI strategy in January 2017. And after that, they also released a detailed document related to this. Japan also released such kind of document in March 2017. And it is not only that they are releasing some kind of strategy documents. At the same time, they are having investments also. Like for building the future workforce for artificial intelligence, countries are also significantly increasing allocation of resources in STEM. STEM means Science, Technology, Engineering and Mathematics. So STEM, talent development, they are having their allocation of resources. For example, UK, they have given example here. UK has planned to build over 1000 government supported PhD researchers, 1000 by 2025, and set up a Turing Fellowship. They have given this name, Turing Fellowship, to support an initial cohort of artificial intelligence fellows. At the same time, China has also launched a 5-year university program to train at least 500 teachers and 5000 students working on artificial intelligence technologies. Then dedicated public offices are being opened in UAE. They have given this name, Ministry of Artificial Intelligence UAE, and Office of AI and AI Council, which is there in UK. So these are at global level, which you can see developments in artificial intelligence. There is also note given here, a study by NASSCOM found that by 2022, around 46% of the workforce will be engaged in entirely new jobs that do not exist today, or will be deployed in such kind of jobs that have radically changed skill sets. So that is the study by NASSCOM, and they are predicting it by 2022. Now, artificial intelligence and India, this was at global level. Now, artificial intelligence in and India, and what are the kind of opportunities we are having? At the start, they have given economic impact of artificial intelligence. And when you talk about economic impact, there are some potential areas where you can see this economic impact. So first of all, intelligent automation. First area, automation. So intelligent automation, that is ability to automate complex physical world that require adaptability and agility across industry. So that is the first area where you can see the impact of artificial intelligence. So industry, manufacturing, there you can see. Then second, labor and capital augmentation. In that case, enabling humans to focus on parts of their role that add the most value. So that is nothing but labor and capital augmentation, where you can use artificial intelligence. So you can enhance the human capabilities by this. And innovation diffusion. Third area is innovation diffusion, that is propelling innovation as it diffuses through the economy. So you are focusing on innovation. Apart from this, you can see in inclusive growth also, social development and inclusive growth, you can see artificial intelligence. So what are the areas where you can find AI application in this? First of all, quality of life, improving the quality of life and access of choices to a larger section of country. And in that case, health facility is very much important. So increased access to quality health facility, that is the first important point here. Then inclusive financial growth for larger section of population, which can enhance the capabilities of people. Then real-time advisory to farmers, in that case also you can find AI application. And then building smart and efficient cities and infrastructure, which is basically important when you are having this rapid urbanization in India. After that, they have given one phrase here, AI garage for 40% of world. So India can become AI garage for 40% of the world. It can solve the problems of 40% of the world through artificial intelligence. So what are the potential areas where you can solve the problems of the world? First of all, healthcare. And in healthcare, first of all, they have given that there is also barrier to healthcare facilities. And because of that, AI can address the issues of high barriers to access of healthcare facilities. And this is particularly in rural areas where you are facing such kind of problem. Now, where you can find AI application then? First of all, AI-driven diagnostics are there. AI-driven diagnostics. After that, personalized treatment you can provide by using AI. Then early identification of potential pandemic. This report was in 2018, but they have given this identification of potential pandemic and imaging diagnostics, among others. So these are various areas where you can find healthcare application. When you talk about agriculture, then there is a promise of driving a food revolution. To ensure food security, you should have this important point here, that is artificial intelligence and its applications in agriculture. Now, where it can help you? Meeting the increased demand for food, and in that case AI can be helpful. Now, they have given one data here that global need to produce 50% more food and cater to an additional 2 billion people by 2050 as compared to today. Now, this is the problem, that you need to produce 50% more food to cater this additional 2 billion population by 2050, and in that case AI can help you. Now, potential to address challenges such as inadequate demand prediction, lack of assured irrigation, and overuse or misuse of pesticides and fertilizers. So, these are some areas where you can find that artificial intelligence can address these challenges. Now, some of the applications are given here, like improvement in the crop yield through real-time advisory, you can use artificial intelligence. Then advanced detection of pest attacks, for that also you can use artificial intelligence. And prediction of crop prices to inform sowing practices. So, these are various areas where you can find artificial intelligence application in agriculture. Apart from that, in this report some boxes are given which are quite important, like application for soil care. Application for soil care. Now, there is one tech startup, Berlin based agriculture tech startup called PEAT, P-E-A-T, and they have developed a deep learning application called as Plantix. Plantix is the name of that deep learning application, which reportedly identifies potential defects and nutrient deficiencies in the soil. So, you can have this AI for soil care. Apart from that, you can also use AI for herbicide optimization. Herbicide optimization. Now, there is one organization, company called Blue River Technology, which has designed and integrated computer vision and machine learning technology. Computer vision and machine learning technology that enables farmer to reduce the use of herbicides by spraying only where the weeds are present. So, you are optimizing the use of herbicides by using machine learning platforms. Then AI for precision farming, another application is given here, and this is by Niti Aayog and IBM. So, they have jointly developed a crop yield prediction model in which you can have a precision farming. So, that is also one of the application of AI in agriculture. Apart from that, next important point is smart mobility including transport and logistics. Smart mobility including transport and logistics. And here automation fleets of ride sharing, then semi-autonomous features like driver assistance and predictive engine monitoring and maintenance. So, these are various areas where you can have artificial intelligence in mobility, in transportation. Other areas like impact of artificial intelligence can be seen on autonomous tracking and delivery of the freight and improved traffic management. So, these are various areas where you can use artificial intelligence. Apart from that, in retail sector, they have given one application in the retail sector, application of AI, like improving user experience by providing personalized suggestions and preference based browsing and image based product search. So, these are various areas where you can find that it can assist consumers, customers in their purchase. After that, other use cases like customer demand anticipation can be done through AI, then improved inventory management and efficient delivery management. So, these are various areas where you can find application of AI. Next, they have given manufacturing. So, in manufacturing, how can you find use of artificial intelligence? So, to enable the factory of future, this word they have used, factory of future, through flexible and adaptable technical systems to automate processes and machinery to respond to unfamiliar or unexpected situations. So, this is basically factory of future, where you can find unexpected or unfamiliar situations and you need to tackle these problems. And if you need to tackle these problems, then there can be help of artificial intelligence. And some impact areas they have given here related to this AI. Engineering, first of all, in engineering section you can use artificial intelligence. So, AI for R&D efforts they have given. Then supply chain management, in supply chain management you can ensure that for demand forecasting artificial intelligence can be used. Then in production, AI can have its impact in cost reduction and increasing the efficiency. After that, maintenance, you can have predictive maintenance tool for artificial intelligence, you can use it, and increased asset utilization can be done through this artificial intelligence. So, maintenance. Then when you talk about manufacturing, there is one important point, quality assurance. And in that case, you can use artificial intelligence to create such kind of algorithms which can assure your quality. And in plant logistics and warehousing, where you can use artificial intelligence. Now, another field where you can find potential application of artificial intelligence, that is energy sector. So, energy system modeling and forecasting to decrease unpredictability and increase the efficiency in power balancing. And when you want to increase the efficiency in power balancing, in that case, you can use this artificial intelligence. So, storage of energy through intelligent grids enabled by smart meters. This is one of the application of AI. Then improve reliability and affordability of photovoltaic energy. You can find AI application here. And it can be deployed for predictive maintenance of grid infrastructure. Grid infrastructure, you can use this AI for predictive maintenance. Next, in case of smart cities, where you can find AI applications. So, it could also help meet the demands of rapidly urbanizing population and providing them with enhanced quality of life, the point which we have earlier discussed. Then potential use cases can be traffic control. When you are talking about smart cities, traffic control is an important point. So, traffic control to reduce congestion and enhanced security through improved crowd management, where you can find this application of AI. Next important field where you can find application, education and skilling. So, in education field, they have given some important examples also here. First of all, augmenting and enhancing the learning experience, which is very crucial, through personalized learning, you can find AI application here. Then automating and expediting administrative tasks in institutes. After that, predicting the need for student intervention to reduce dropouts or recommend vocational training. And when you talk about dropouts, there is one important tool developed by Microsoft, which is also used in Andhra Pradesh. So, Microsoft is helping in predicting dropouts in Andhra Pradesh by using their machine learning tool called as Azure. A-Z-U-R-E. Azure machine learning tool is there of Microsoft, and they have used this tool to predict that how many or what percentage of students are getting dropout in Andhra Pradesh. And accordingly, the government has reacted to it. Then apart from that, creating smart content for improved interactivity, where you can find AI application. There is one company called as Content Technology Industry, CTI, and is AI research and development company, which develops AI that creates customized educational content for improved interactivity. This kind of tool is being developed. Then there is one more tool called as Right to Learn. So Right to Learn software by Pearson. It uses natural languages processing technology to give students personalized feedback, hints and tips to improve their writing skills. So, to improve writing skills, this platform is helping students by giving them personalized feedback. So, it is a natural language processing technology which is used in this Pearson's Right to Learn software. Now, apart from this, what are the key challenges? Till now, we have seen what are the various areas where you can find potential application of AI. Now, what are the key challenges in adoption of this artificial intelligence in India? Key challenges. Then, some challenges they have given here, like lack of enabling data ecosystem. Data is very much important. So you need to create a proper data ecosystem where you can find data is available in specified format. So, lack of enabling data ecosystem, first point. Then low intensity of AI research, some important data they have given later in this report. Core research in fundamental technologies is lacking, and then transforming core research into market applications is also crucial, which is also lacking. Then third point, which you can say challenge, inadequate availability of AI expertise, manpower and skilling opportunities are also lacking here. Then unclear privacy, security and ethical regulations, which is very much important. You need to have strong regulations related to this. And then unattractive intellectual property regime to incentivize research and adoption of artificial intelligence. So these are some challenges which are given in this report. Now, where does India stand then? If these are the challenges, then where does India stand in this AI research? AI research, where does India stand? First of all, we are having a lot of tools, utility, you can say, related to AI. Like we are having expertise, you can say. educated talent pool is there. First of all, you are having educated talent pool. Then world-class educational institutes are there. And if these things are available, then where does we stand? So there is one fact given here that disappointingly though, an overwhelming majority of this talent pool. So when we say in challenge that there is lack of or inadequate availability of AI expertise, in that case, why we say this kind of thing? Because there is one data given here that overwhelmingly majority of this talent pool, which we are already having talent pool, it focuses on routine IT development and it is not tilting towards research and innovation. Now that is the big point here. Now there is one report given to support this data also, that as per the Global AI Talent Report 2018, which crawled LinkedIn for its analysis, it used LinkedIn, India only has 386 of a total of 22,000 PhD educated researchers worldwide. So out of 22,000, you are having only 386 these researchers. And in that case, India is ranked 10th globally. And in terms of citable documents, which are published in the field of AI, they are talking in between 2010 and 2016. They have given India ranks a distant 5th. India is at 5th rank, far behind the likes of China and USA, and just about edging ahead of Germany and France. But you cannot rely on this that we are ahead of Germany and France, because it is having considerably smaller STEM population. And in that case also, they are having a better number of citable documents. Now, next important point is ethics. So ethics and artificial intelligence. The article was also focusing on this point, ethics and artificial intelligence. And in that case, fairness and transparency, these two points are highlighted in this report. And apart from that, privacy and artificial intelligence, related to that, some data is given here, like data collection without proper consent. That is nothing but when you say informed consent is necessary, that is lacking here. Then privacy of personal data. After that, inherent selection biases and resultant risk of profiling and discrimination. Some kind of examples already given in this article, we have already seen. And non-transparent nature of AI solutions. So these are some kind of issues which you can count in privacy issue related to AI. After that, they are talking about some concerns then. So there are concerns that companies are harvesting significant amount of consumer data and using it inappropriately to gain insights about consumers. And that is very well accepted also. Then concerns that companies are amassing large data sets and thereby building an unfair competitive advantage. So these two points are given in concerns related to AI, which you can count in privacy. So concerns about privacy in AI. Now security, now the last point in this report, security in artificial intelligence. And what kind of framework you can have related to security then? First of all, you can have negligence test for damages caused for AI software. So if there is AI software and it create any kind of damage, you can first pass the software through negligence test. After that, framework for appointment of damages need to be developed so that the involved parties bear proportionate liability related to that damage. So security in AI, they have given this kind of framework. And in the last, they have given that India can also leap out a page from UK's playbook. That means they are saying that you can have some kind of framework like UK, where 9 million pound is being invested to establish a new center related to ethics. We are talking that they have invested 9 million pounds to establish a new center for data ethics and innovation, aimed at enabling and ensuring ethical, safe and innovative use of data, including AI. So related to AI, you should have ethical, safe and innovative use of data. And for that purpose, in UK, they have started a new center for data ethics and innovation. So that means related to ethics, they have given some important details in this report. And by same name, you are having this article also. So this was article related to artificial intelligence from The Hindu. And related to that, some important factual details like this roadmap on digital cooperation. This can be a question in prelims. At the same time, in mains, already they have asked some questions. In 2019, there was essay on artificial intelligence. And in your GS3 paper, awareness in the field of information technology, there also you can find some kind of question related to AI. And this national strategy for artificial intelligence in that context will be beneficial for you. So this is from today's video related to AI. We will have similar kind of videos in our next sessions. Thank you.